Hello. Hello to the people. Should be live now. And wait the obligatory couple of seconds for everyone to catch up. And CS, is that how you say it? Case? Khaki? Khaki? 261. Yes, Warhammer 40,000 is like crack to me. I used to actually play pen and paper roleplay, Dark Heresy, and I was the games master. And it's an awesome game. Awesome universe, awesome lore, so much lore. Such a good game. And series of games. Been bastardized a little bit over the years, though. Hey, welcome, Lightning Dragon. Got your laundry sorted then? So is the stream quality, like, is there much buffering or anything for everyone? Is it working? Sweet, so everything's working. I love that. Love it when it works. Love it when a plan comes together. Right. We're coming up to starting time. A few more minutes. We're nearly there. Don't have to wait much longer. Then I can unveil the secret project. Hooray! I've spent maybe 15 to 20 hours on this so far. I love the A-Team. Man, I was actually really surprised. I say new movie, but the remake, it was actually brilliant. I really, really enjoyed it. It was utterly stupid, but really enjoyable. So surprised that it was really good. I, of course, grew up with the original A-Team because, well, they're awesome. And I'm a bit old. So, I think we can probably change the game footage. Let's switch over to game footage. And I will load this fella in. And it's currently lovingly named Airship. Because I haven't got a name for it yet. But, let's hop into the cockpit. And rather than go for the full outside view, we're going to have a walking tour. Because this is fully walkable. Hurrah! Well, I say fully walkable, the back section you can't get to. But it's, yeah. It's for, it actually started out as something completely different. Oh, I've still got control of the guns. And there are a lot of guns. There are 26 weapon systems on this. There are a bunch of little tiny turrets. And there's a few particle cannons, and there's missiles, and there's cram cannons, and there's guns in the cockpit. Or, you know, in case the boss wants to get a bit of DACA in as well, he can fire from here. Hurrah. But I think I'm going to add more of these little in-hull turrets. They're pointless, but, you know, they're fun. Oh, is everyone getting... can everyone see stuff? And yes, Bone Dragon, there are drills everywhere. And they spin too. They don't actually do anything, they're strictly for aesthetics. And I've, this is a pointlessly expensive thing. It's nearly 1 million RP. space if there's a gun, yeah. More or less everything is for effects. I've even got, advanced cannon pieces on the cram cannon and stuff like that, and laser pieces and stuff everywhere. But this is the cockpit just. So, and they are all AI controlled as well, so we don't have to worry about that. They will fire. So let's hop along the top here, and that's one of the particle cannons. Binoculars out and have a better look. A couple of laser parts, and that's not actually connected to anything. There's no power in it. Well, there's a little bit of power, but it's not actually connected to that optics. Just because, unless you have a certain amount of damage, it'll only go about sort of this far, and it looks really stupid. So I had to just like kill it and make sure that it doesn't actually do anything. Now, where's next? This is another one of the little turrets, and it's a bit of a throw together, really. Turn this off. And these are not made to be effective. They fire one block Subo powders. They're strictly for the Daka, because obviously in any orc ship you have to have the Daka, and all of these drill segments turn. Oh, I tell a lie, there's one, or well, two technically, that don't turn, and they're right in the teal, so we can't. We'll see them at the very back later. Ah, cut my face off. These are APN frags? Explosives. And they pop out at about 900 meters from the target and sort of seal down. They look pretty cool when they fire. What else? We've got the teal back here. And I decided to go entirely with propellers. Now, I gotta say, the new custom jet engines would be really cool for this build, but they are such fuel guzzlers. That I decided against them, and it was sort of too late into the build whenever I decided that they would be a good idea, so I didn't really have the, you know, account for them, and they wouldn't work in this case. But that is the back, and there are some more Daka on the end there, and that is a really wacky turret, because there is a mixture of normal autoloaders and belt feeders on them. So, yeah, that's a thing. Why the hell not? As I said, not meant to be effective, but meant to be stupid and fun. Bone Dragon, I actually have Battlefleet Gothic. I did buy it. I pre-ordered it, actually. After they decided to release extra DLC at the start, because I was honestly a little bit miffed that they decided to go, you know, so heavy on the DLC, especially release DLC, but then they offered it as a pre-order bonus, so kind of, you know, kudos to the devs for that, sort of listening to the community, so I decided to make a purchase. We will get to the making things go boom. We haven't even looked at the whole ship yet. There is a lot to get around. This is like the ammo dump, and I've got a little walkway up to it with a nice little box, and it's higher up so the grots can't get at it, because we don't want grots playing with guns. They that could lead to accidents. There are three red lines here. There's one hidden in the roof there. Can you even see it from here? Yeah, you can. One there, another one there, another one there. There's actually two in the back. Behind that wall, there is the turret. We'll have to go into third person to get to that. And this is the starting area. It's like the load up area for all the stuff. We've got storage tanks and metal, lots and lots of metal. The other side of that, we have the, whatchamacallit, the pitch control thruster things, but they're actually everything is controlled by daddy blades. There are no thrusters on this. There are thrusters on the front, but they're the only ones on the entire ship. These clips are just aesthetic reasons. It feeds into that and feeds into that. I think it looks pretty cool. It's like a sort of working mechanical contraption type thing. A similar sort of idea here, and barrels for aesthetics for like pillar things. And we have a slidey pole here rather than a ladder. I'll hop up here, and this goes back into the bridge. Oh, open the door. Let me in. Let me in. Oop. And close the door after us. Close this door. Hop back into the pilot seat, and we can actually have a proper look at what the whole thing looks like as a whole. And the whole reason, the entire reason that it turned into an Orky ship was because I kind of built this and it looked a bit like an Orky face, and that's just how it turned out. But there are still quite a lot of little bits to do here. These turrets I built before I built the Orky face, so they need to be sort of revamped. I don't think they look very Orky. I think these banisters need to be changed. They need to be orcified up as well, because orcs would not use banisters, like just not in their nature. Something to hold on to might be handy, but a lot of the time you just throw the grots off the side, be fine. Particle cannons I'm pretty happy with. I think they look badass. Very suitably Orky, and will, I think, be improved by paint, which obviously this whole thing needs. I did go and paint these. I'm not too happy with the paint job, and I don't think my fleet colours are going to work for this. So I'm probably going to repaint these to be something a little bit different. There's a little bit more aesthetic detailing here, and just for absolutely no reason at all, there are a couple of pram barrels with the elevation barrel and motor drivens, just to give a bit of texture. Again, that'll benefit from the, whatchamacallit, bit of paint. This is the illustrious 4-barrel, I think it's 1.8 or something like that, 1.9 meter, okay, so it's bigger than that. Ram cannon. It's a big fella. It's about as big as the coastal defense one that I built, actually. Probably bigger than the one in the Mastiff as well. But these are actually jet parts, and they look freaking awesome. And there's a couple of gauge increasers and another one of the jet parts, just for aesthetics. It looks pretty cool. And a little laser targeter thing here for basically no reason at all. But if we look in the inside, we'll see how big the actual turret is. And this is a bit of a monster. We'll shrinky it down. We're upside down now. Whoop, there we go. And yeah, that's a few things. Just a few. And these are all inertial, penetration, what's the other one? Thingy. The fuse box. There we go. Time from launch, yeah, timed inertial penetration depth. They're pretty nasty cannons. Pretty nasty cannons. Bring that down again. Build mode. Where's next on the tour? Yep, more red lines here. Lots more red lines. I still think we need more fuel, which I'll probably just cram into this room somewhere. What else do we have? There's a basic, very basic flare launcher at the back. We're onto our lovely propellers at the back here. There's ACBs in the middle here controlling all of these. And they're actually set to speed up and slow down based on whether there are enemies present. So when there are no enemies, they slow down, because I had troubles with this thing sort of blitzing away and running off the map. what else? I think this is more or less it. These are... I'm pretty happy with this. This is my Daddy Blade powered yaw control. There are ACBs in here somewhere. There they are. And they're just programmed to turn left and right. They'll activate it when control received to yaw right. They turn them up. And whenever you receive the control to yaw left, I can get the ACB up. They go the other direction. And then the one in the middle is just to stop it whenever it's in between, and there's like a time delay on that, and it's always activating. So yeah, that's how you do that. What else? I think that's more or less it. I still want to add more DACA. Always want to add more DACA. There is actually a missile bay in here, and these use short-range thrusters that drop with ejectors and trigger after, I think, 2 or 3 seconds. So they have like a time delay launch with a one turn as well, so they look really cool. But obviously, I have talked for long enough. It is pretty fragile, but it's it can take out a bulwark if I'm on board. So... Let's get a bulwark. Off you go, my friend. Oomph, rams. Oh yeah, and the pièce de résistance. Yeah, if I can speak. We have a nice orky head here. For, you know, scaring the enemies. That sort of a thing. It's very important to notify, you know, everyone that they must die. Because you are an orc command ship and must destroy the world. Or... Ah. Let's go over to the bulwark. Spaceship. What spaceship? Oh yeah, I did mention that, Bone Dragon. The thrusters are so pricey in terms of fuel. The insta-rotate function. I have never used that. That's probably a good idea. They work pretty well as they are, though, to be honest. Wadaka. There's the little bombs. A lot of this thing is more about the DACA than anything else. Most of the guns are pretty ineffective. The cram cannons do most of the damage, and really need some shields. Well, that could help. We've lost our main cram cannon. Blast! But the particle cannons normally do a really good job of taking out the enemy's turrets and stuff like that. Oh no, no, no. Thank you. That was close. Why are you taking so long to turn now? Oh, the AI is dead. That is why. Now, where is the AI? It is in here. Last. Oh, hang on. We're in the command seat. Let's sort this out ourselves. Here we go. Oh, just like regular jet engines. Where do I have room for them? I could pin on a couple of small ones, but I don't know. I kind of wanted to avoid jets completely with this thing, just because, more than anything else. Are we going in the right direction now? Oh, there we go. Opening fire. Our propulsion started to balance again. The AI back in. It is. It's got control. Sweet. Now we've lost one of our particle cannons. We've lost the other half of that one. Excellent. No, the drills, they don't do anything. They're strictly for aesthetics. The only problem with them is they remain yellow whenever you can't paint them still, so I can't. I have to take that into account whenever I'm painting the ship. But the weapon systems on this sort of lend themselves very well to the Bad Moon clan, which is an orc clan, and they tend to be more technological based. They're the like freebooters and stuff like that. Tends to be more flash gates in their sort of command, and they tend to have they sort of fit the merchant role of orcs, based on the lore anyway. So I'm probably going to have to go with sort of a black and yellow color scheme to work along with that, and we'll do without the red maybe. The yellow we have already, so we can just work around this color. Yeah, another thing I have to add is shields. Shields are massively important here, and that's about the only reason that I take any damage from this bulwark. We have actually about, I think, 8,000 energy engine power left. It's absolutely stacked to the gills with engines. It's got loads and loads of engines, so we have loads of room for shields and stuff. Yeah, the ones in Battlefleet Gothic are sort of, well, the orcs in particular are based around ramming people. So, they're, oh wow. I do love how airships list like this. It looks so awesome. I have control of the weapons. Dude, that's why it isn't firing. We're on. The orc ships in Battlefleet Gothic are very much dependent on ramming. But FDD doesn't lend itself very well to that. For the big nasty bulwark shells, you want probably long distance disrupt shields, to be honest. I don't think they're inertials, but high angle shields will do a pretty good job of just pinging them away again. I think pure high explosive, they have really low AP values, so like weak shields is enough to ping them away. Yes, well, it is too well formed for an orc ship inferior. I completely agree with you, because it was sort of initially intended to be something completely different. But with the orky bits, I ended up sort of going whole hog. We're slowly getting built again. It does have some repair bots on, but really probably not enough to work properly for this. Why can you not put particle cannons in turrets? What is their what is the problem? They should just go right on there. You sometimes have to build like a little scaffolding first to get them to fit. because they only connect from the back center block. Okay, this battle isn't going as well as they normally do. Normally it has the bulwark probably about 90% by this stage. Oh yeah, Bone Dragon. The orcs are extremely stylish. And they're very, very well done. hi Foxy. The orcs have great style. I haven't tried the Eldar yet, actually. They seem pretty interesting, but really, really micro-heavy. Because you have to keep them moving at all times. And a lot of them have prow-mounted cannons, so... the main weapon on this ship is this absurd cram cannon on the bottom, which has currently seen better days. I really hope that doesn't fire like that. Please don't fire like that, that will make an awful mess. Exit! Exit! But yeah, it still needs some work. I mean, this is far from finished. We have lots of little things to add still. Eyes too. Little dim red lights. Ow! Okay, that bit was important. I needed that bit. Git. I think he just got a good start on us. And he is kicking our ass quite a bit. Despite me being on board. This is shameful. You call yourselves orcs? Just replace the hull with missiles. Yeah, that's a great idea. Because missiles aren't explosive. Yeah, Lightning Dragon, the one thing that this is lacking the most is shields. And a couple of shields will make it a lot more survivable. Like, a lot more survivable. There's even, like, a bunch of really high distance strength 1 shields along the bottom here. Just to cover that cram cannon will really help it out. There's a lot of the damage to my daddy blades is coming from these little flak shells. At least against this bulwark, anyway. It can keep flying for a considerable length of time, though. Those deadly blades on the top seem to rarely get hit. And they're all sort of like strutted in 2 or 3 places, so that they don't... Whenever one mount gets destroyed, the rest don't. Oh, hi, Jean-Claude. Underslung crams. Stopping it from shooting itself is a real pain in the ass, and I am just sort of putting them there and hoping for the best. I haven't set any limitations, because the azimuth thing confuses the hell out of me at the best of times, and when you're upside down, it's even more so. Yeah. Needs harpoons or something like that. Or at least a harpoon ship to accompany it. And lift the bulwark out of the air. Or out of the water. Enzige, I'm going to be streaming for another hour and a half, hour 45 minutes. Oh, we are not doing much to this bulwark because the git keeps taking out our cram cannons. He's repairing way faster than we are. You going to disappear? I've run into some recent problems with getting bulwarks to disappear, actually. But we haven't made any changes, so let's just restart the designer. Get rid of all this extra crap. We'll start making some changes. Well, additions, more so. We do have to do shields. I kind of don't want to spend too much time doing shields, because that's going to be kind of boring. So, should we paint it? I think we should paint it. And... there is actually a really awesome tool that I found to enable you to paint things way faster. And I have no idea whether this thing is new or not, but it's freaking awesome. It's in the... items? Is it items? Paint sprayer, yeah. This little feller here I don't remember seeing this thing before, but if you right click, it brings up your colors and you can paint things. And obviously that is not staying like that, even though it's a fabulous color. So vehicle, the lead blocks of the harpoon attached. That's a pretty cool idea, actually. There are more technical challenges to that than you might realize, but it's a really cool idea. So I think we're going to have to go with a sort of dull, slightly dull metal color. And I'm going to use some wood, actually, on the top and stuff to, you know, change the colors up a little bit. I don't think we have to worry too much about having a perfect paint job here. I think that's decidedly un-orky. So, you can imagine bits being sort of stolen off other vehicles and stuff like that. Rusty bits. We can color some of it a lot better. I mean, you know, properly. The one thing I really love about this paint sprayer tool is the fact that you can paint turrets without having to go onto them and select them and all that. That is such, so useful. Unfortunately, this is the other problem. You can't reach blocks that are behind other blocks, so you have to paint them manually in paint mode. But we should be able to get like a slightly darker shade here. I think I want to make that color darker too. Where are you? Color, there you are. Intensity. Yeah, that's a bit better. Ah, no, don't want to paint you. God damn it. Another thing I noticed about this is there's actually a brush size thing as well. But we don't want to play with that just yet. Oh, that's the wrong color. You? No, which one is it? Oh, fleet trim. There we go. We'll probably have to repaint that guy at the end anyway. No, I missed it, Bone Dragon. Sorry. What do you mean I'm boarding? I know you said about that the orcs would board by now, but... And it would certainly be a suitably orky thing to do. Fortunately, it's a pretty awkward thing to do in this game. Brush size. I want to change the brush size. Because that makes things a lot faster. Ah, now we're talking. Look at that. This is how you paint things rapidly. Okay, we can repaint that after. Oh yes, saves so much time. He just sprays it everywhere. This is so handy. Forgot how useful this is. Just a bit. Missing bits everywhere, but not a lot I can do about them. They're all inside. There's like a base coat for anyone that's, you know, done the whole Warhammer thing in the past. Start yourself with your undercoat, and you layer the detail on top of that. How long is the orc? You mean the ship? The ship is 84 meters long. Which is pretty long, which is very big for me. I don't often build ships even half this size. Oh, damn. Yeah, Bill Snow, that is so annoying. And sometimes it does it, like, seemingly randomly. Because you would expect it to work every time on which mass is the highest, but it doesn't seem to happen all the time like that. A real pain. Oh, that was a very, very quick paint job compared to what would normally happen. We need to add some details. We have all these yellowy bits. I was thinking about putting the NPCs on this, actually. Tommy asked, did you miss the boom boom? I was shooting at a bulwark for a while. Oh yeah, nice. In from the inside too. Instantly darker. This is about like 2 layers thick in most places. More so in others. Still gonna require a lot of tidying up. Oops. And I will be doing quite a lot of this. I mean, there's no way I'm going to actually be able to finish this during the stream, so there's still going to be a lot more to this build. I do plan to do a YouTube video around it as well, proper montage-y things and stuff like that. I have some ideas about it. But I do love the orcs and sort of all of the lore behind them and things like that, so, you know, there might be a bit of that in the video. I think we're nearly done. Yeah, these ones on the back, these drills, are the only ones that don't spin on the whole thing. De facto, there is kind of a paint all the things button. You can kind of cheat by you go into your paint colors and set the 01. Which is the default to whatever color you want it to be, and that'll act like your base coat. The trouble is it colors all your components as well. If it's a flash get ship, they're not really the biggest fasty people, but at the same time I'll probably make the propellers red. I must admit, I am very, very tempted to add thrusters. Oh, Dragon, that's totally your fault. Let's see what happens if I add thrusters. Just little ones. Oh, forgot my symmetry. Always forget my symmetry. That actually covers those wee things off really nicely. I like that. That looks great. Even if they don't add very much speed, they're really cool. Yeah, Inferio, the orc lore behind their magic system is really cool. Like, the orcs are all like latently powerful super psychers, and each and every one of them is like a psyker, and whenever there's a load of them together, the power of the Wah, it all sort of works together, and they can do like crazy stuff, and they've been observed by like space marines and like imperial people that have seen them like totally emptily like take a clip out of a gun that is empty and put the same clip straight back in again and start shooting again, because the orc magic just sort of fills it up again and they magically shoot extra bullets. And oh my god, Ben, seriously? Thank you, man. I really appreciate that. That's a tip from Ben the Daddy. Thank you. I really appreciate that. Thank you very much, man. That's really cool of you. So yeah, that's my first ever tip. Wow, typical Ben, you and your firsts. You have got a few of them on the channel. Oh, right, okay. I'm a bit flabbergasted about getting a tip now, thank you. You got me all teary and stuff. So, right, what are we going to do then? What do we want to do next? We've got a quick and dirty paint job, but there's still a lot more detail to go on this, because I want to take these pipes off. In fact, let's just freaking do it, because that does not look orky enough at all. Orcs don't do that. They will just like step on the grots or stop them from falling off somehow. Orcs are very sure-footed. They're like mountain goats, big green dumb mountain goats. Shields, yes, Okay, we're doing shields. Let us start at the front with some shields. Misc. Shield. Oh, you. Shield projector. No, what way do I want to do this? I'm going to make these really dark colored. I have room to put some armor around that, so I will do that after. And let's set up a basic one, and strength. This is a pretty important part, so we'll go for a high strength shield here. Doesn't need to be that big either. Oh, wrong way. Damn it. Needs to be further out than that though. We have loads of power free, so we can afford to be a bit crazy on the shields. Well, that's a really expensive one to be making so big. Probably don't want to go mad on that. Okay, it's a good start, I think. And we'll copy that. Copy that. And then pop another two here. You're really lazy with the configuration. Oh, no way, that works kind of. Let's turn it a little bit. Make it a little bit weaker. And a little bit bigger. These are just going to be the inside shields. And I'm going to put like a sort of a small blanket of long distance disrupt shields as well, I think. We have the clipboard, move it to the other side. These from clipboard. And then change the azimuth so it's the right way around. Yay! There is a small selection of shields. Oh yeah, man, it'd be nice to be able to have more smoke outlets. But you kind of need a pretty big, dense engine to actually get lots of smoke. Are there actually smoke generators? I don't think there are smoke generators in the game. If you could shield offset by like up and down, left and right, like on the XY axis, that would be pretty cool. You paid the, you know, price for distance for it as well. That'd be cool. It would be a nice little configuration bonus. Disrupt shields don't need that much strength to be useful at all. They're kind of a bit random. It's sort of percentage based, really. So the more you give them, the better they are, basically. But it's still percentage based, so you can still find them not actually working, even when they're strength 10. Whereas weak ones can sometimes work. it's a bit strange. This is the ever fun part of fitting in shields everywhere. Pull that down a bit. Angle. Not that way. That away. Is that too close to the hull? I'd say it probably is. Nah, it's not close enough to the front either. Don't like that, but then I don't really want to worry about going up, you know, into full, total 100% shield coverage, because we'll be here all day setting them up, and I honestly find setting up shields really tedious. Much is that? 300 power. That'll do. I'll probably go around and tweak all of these quite a bit later on. Oh, that's an ammo processor. Shield projector. That kind of works, but this is the wrong way around. Not that it should really have any azimuth at all. But hey, whatevs, and it works. I wonder, is there anywhere I can put? Yeah, probably. Here, nicely. What was over there? Oh no, wait, there's ammo. When did I break that? Right, we want to keep it a bit away from the ammo boxes then. The other side there. A little too close. The big shield on a two axis. Yeah, that it does work, but only against a single enemy. Whenever there's other enemies in play, it you kind of put all your eggs in one basket. And whenever the shield gets destroyed or the turret gets destroyed, you lose all your shields at once. So it can be really nasty. It can be effective too, don't get me wrong. Alright, a little bit more of that, a little bit more of that. And we need to turn it. Oh, not really that way, but a little bit that way wouldn't hurt. And I think we need to make it taller. Not the right way. Is it? Oh, it is. And pull it down a bit that way. No. I want a wider. Shorter. I'm not so concerned if there's a few gaps. Oh, I turned the shield off. How much is this one? Isn't so bad. I think 4. It's even a bit much, to be honest. Because we will have disrupt shields in here as well. Even that's still too wide, too. Wasting loads of shield coverage. Most of the attacks are going to be coming from below and from the front and back because of the way this thing flies. Oh, Bob Reader, thank you very much. Appreciate it, man. I really need to set up a sound for that so that I don't miss donations and stuff like that. Because that's unfair. Base from tip board. Oh, yeah. Thank you very much for another donation. I do really appreciate that. Not necessary by any means, guys. Just to throw that out there. So don't feel obliged to sending me money, but it's really nice. I do appreciate it. Flying refinery. The problem with the flying refinery is they have to stay vertical, like otherwise they get unstable and can potentially explode. And with an airship, if you lose some of your stability and they explode, you've got a time bomb in your ship, which is kind of funny. But a bit of a glass cannon, really. Not a great idea. I like that idea for the small shields to maximize the angle of incidence. That's clever. That would require a bit of sciencey stuff, I think. But I do like the idea. Hardly, Ben. Jeez. All day streaming. Wow. Not sure I could do it, to be honest. Actually playing and talking to you guys at the same time is really hard. I have enough trouble talking and playing at the same time when I'm doing videos. But talking and playing and reading chat too, that is a challenge. Back to the shield projectors. And yeah, I think we do want something here. Don't think I'm going to go with a full strength shield here. We're going to go with long distance ones, I think. Just the disrupt shields. And we'll make them freaking massive because they're going to be strength ones. That's the trouble with these. I don't like where they're placed. I often put these in like the most weird directions. Just facing them downwards seems to be actually way more useful for this. Doesn't need to be huge distance in that direction, but gouge and turn it way and that. Nah, that doesn't work either. Damn it! You have so few configuration options whenever you're using high distance shields. That's in an absolutely rubbish position. Yeah, back to the other one. Oi. Give me the shield, please. Oh, right. Whoops. And hi, Kiwis. We'll fly. Troubled us. Thank you. Everyone's getting their wallets out today. Was it payday or something? It is pay weekend in the UK. Thank you very much. Oh yeah, I've seen that Azumandrit. Azumandrit, is that right? I kind of took a running leap at it and kind of feel horribly. But yeah, it's Nick has sort of decided to leave space seals working. So seals officially work in space and will continue to do so for the foreseeable future, which is kind of funny. I have to have a go at making a space seal. You can kind of exploit the drag mechanics and get some thrust out of seals, which is hilarious. Elevation down and that away. Just a little. And protect some of it coming from that direction, and I think we'll put one at the bottom as well. Copy that and get the other side set up first. This is probably not the most opportune way to do this, but the most efficient way. But it will have to do. We'll turn this way and put another one on. Just paste in the same settings and turn it a wee bit more. I am worried it's going to crash into that mountain though. And pull the distance back. And turn that back a bit more. Nice little shieldy box. Hooray! Probably be higher distance, but just don't really have the room for it. So cheap. Make them stronger so we get bigger incidence changes. Okay, that's a lot more expensive. We want to keep these relatively cheap. And the strength too. And strength two. Let's copy this one as well so we can move it to the other side. There we go. Fished. And reverse. Nice. None of the weather's horrible this. That sucks. Cold flu type thing. Let's set this to be a little bit further away. Shields everywhere. First that. There we go. Okay, so that's a fair crack of shields. It is a few. It is a start. We need more. More shields! That would be really awesome, Bill Snow. That'd be really handy. I seen actually that someone made a mod for colorized shields. With like a built-in shield colorizer, which is ingenious, because I believe that was supposed to be impossible based on the game's code, but it might have been possible now with the way that the modding thing has been implemented, which is pretty interesting. Delicious coffee, which is now kind of cold because I've been talking for ages. Don't worry, it'll not last long. It is not long for this world. Now, where are we going to put more shields? Damn it. It's really in the way, actually. Ah, I knew I left this here for a reason. Put shields in here. Make like super strong reflect shields. Don't even really have to angle these. Don't need to be any taller than that really either. Well, I guess we want to defend our thingies as well. Thingies? Yeah, defend your thingies, guys. Very important. Maybe turn this back a little bit. Just to increase the angle of incidence. Hello. Pretty wasteful in terms of energy coverage. You know, it's... like, all this stuff at the top is kind of wasted. It does a little bit in protecting these steady blades, but very little. So we're essentially wasting half of the power there, but... yeah, you know. Kind of limited on actually, you know, the places that we can place the damn thing. Where are ya? There we go. That seems to be reversed still. Whoops. Clink! Right. That is more shields. I believe we need more. Bill Snow, I have 5 redline engines in them. Each one of them puts out 3200 power. But they're pretty efficient. Like, maybe 10% of the total mass of this thing is engines. Sammy has a... Headcrab is playing Arma 3 at the minute. At least I think he still is. At least he hasn't bugged me on Skype yet. He might be sneakily hiding in the stream somewhere too. Now, where do we put more shields? Really want to protect these things back. Oh, perfect. And reflect shields? I'm not so worried about reflect shields at the back here, to be honest. Then I might just go with lots of long-distance disrupts. Make them bigger. Bigger, bigger, bigger. Come on. Ah, so I can see it. Then put a big spin on it. And that's bloody useless. Totally useless. That is like in the worst place possible. That's completely crap. Why do we push it way far out? I guess it works. Oh, okay, that's better. That might actually do something. Although they are only disrupt shields, though. Grand total of 156 energy, though, at 25. That's really cheap. Kind of feel like our ship is getting away a little bit here as well. Now, where do I leave that bloody shield? So hard to find stuff in this. Aha! Christ. Turn this boy round. Negative! Okay. Another shield successfully added. I'll have a quick look up and down chat here, because I got actually a lot of spam from people joining and leaving. I should probably stop using the IRC client for this. Yeep! You prank call him. I kind of told him I was streaming, so I can't really prank call him, I'm afraid. Ermagerd. So many people. Good to have so many people here. Most has been building and talking. This is a building and talking stream. Well, what do you propose in terms of prank calls? Because A, if I call him, he knows it's going to be me. B, he knows I'm streaming. And C, that kind of makes it all not a prank call. Oh man, for faction designs, there are so many people. Oh, I just realized I haven't saved this thing in ages. Or did I? I think I might have just saved it. I have a habit of doing that. We need more shields. We need shields at the bottom of this cannon. That's really important because that is somewhere that's actually taking some damage. Room behind it, that'd be perfect. This here might do. Pretty these up in terms of what they do later. Oh, I think we're going to lose our cram cannon here. Oop. Aha! Saved by caps lock. No. Out of way. Way taller. No, taller. Well, that actually connects quite nicely. Lovely. And got a bit stronger. And based. Get rid of the negative. Okay. We have a lot of shields. Oh, good point, Swarble. I totally should be able to do that. I used to spend a lot of time on IRC clients. But I'm a bit out of practice, to say the least. I even dabbled in scripting and stuff like that. But that is literally 10 years ago. I think we're about, like, 2 or 3 meters off the ground here. pretty close. And that little hill just ahead of us there would definitely beach us. Which is not good. I think we're nearing the time to restart the designer, because as I was saying before about it sort of taking off and going on its own little journey around the world off the main map. I think we should probably test this again. I do. Oh, actually, no. Let's at least put some here. Alright, where do I put it here is the question. Don't think we need these. Fact, no. Long distance disrupt shields. Ah, whoopa! Huge shields. Oh, that's the wrong button. There we go. That's the one I want. And that away. And go up to strength. Ooh, no, that's expensive. There we go. Paper disrupt shields about 200. And copy. Dad. And paste. Right, we have loads of shields now. Let us save, restart the designer, and give it a quick test. Probably needs more though. By the time it gets altitude. Okay, thank you for the suggestion on the thrusters. That was a really good suggestion. That looks badass. It was Bone Dragon, I think. Thank you, sir. Okay, so let's see how we do against a bulwark again. Seeing as we have some lovely shields. I think I'm going to have to put some on the back as well, because this thing does actually spend a lot of time with its ass to the enemy. Which is probably not a good idea. You should never leave your ass exposed. Especially not to the enemy. Do we? Go over and see what the bullets are actually doing. Woof. Dramatic shot there. Straight out of a montage. You know, we're not close enough yet. Ha 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 ha. The beautiful F11 key. I do love EMPs. They do look so pretty. Alright, we're ready. And action! Usually disappointing damage, considering the shell. It's not a bad hole there. Those particle cannons just look so damn cool. And you missed. Yeah, rear guns is probably a good idea, Bone Dragon. I do have a couple of... well, I have those little turrets prefab, so I'll probably just stick a few of them on wherever I can. Konizan, Konizian Emperor? Not recording for YouTube specifically, but this will go up as a VOD afterwards. So you'll be able to see yourself on YouTube then. So what sort of damage are we taking this time? 98% to 98%. Well, it's a vast improvement anyway. Not sure if we actually, you know, deflected any shells, so to speak. But it might have. I do need to tweak the AI settings too, definitely. Because it's a bit, well, fiddly. It goes too far away and takes too long to go back again. Although that sort of helps the cram cannon quite a bit because it's the main damage dealer. And staying farther away is probably a good thing. I have got control of the bloody guns again. The only trouble with having the AI off, or the UI off, all these AI, oh geez, that hurt. I don't think it's going to hurt as much as this is going to hurt, though. Ugh, all that beautiful DACA. Lovely! Look at that! Fortunately, that block confetti is coming from us. That looks very promising. I approve of this. Oh, still connected. Haha! You've been stubbied, son. Damn it. They look like they're going to hit. No! They hit us right in the giblets. Okay, the cram cannon's fine. There's a second barrage. Aha! Take that in the face. Oh, that took the whole turret out. Excellent. Excellent! This is much better than last time. Yes, Alshigan, this is what happens when you mention airships. I've already got multiple particle cannons. There's two on it already. The payload for the crams is high explosive with hardener, so they're quite high AP. They're about maybe 60 AP, and I'm honestly not sure about the explosive damage. I never checked it, but it is a 4-barrel. We're definitely going to incorporate some red into it. Oh wow, we're listing pretty bad here. What do we lose? Ha ha. The important thing is it's still flying, though. I approve of this. I can't believe it's taken me so long to start building airships. Because they fly so utterly cool. So very cool. They're just quite weak, I find. Particle cannons, eh? I have an idea. Don't really have the power for it, though. The only trouble with particle cannons, you kind of have to build with them in mind from the start because they are so expensive on power. Taking a lot of damage here. I think we do need some, like, basic reflect shields down there. Although this thing, I think, uses timed shield, or timed heat advanced cannon shells on their little black cannons. Aha! Take that in the face. Didn't like that, did you? Particles for the particle cannon gods. Very good. Yeah, a few people have suggested an ion cannon in Easy Ant, and that is... it is definitely something that would look the part.
Yeah, I'll shoot gun. The ones in the back are for turning. Just for turning. Harpoons are a lot of fun, though. Wouldn't be too hard to mount, like, a stupid amount of harpoons on this, but it doesn't have the lift. It's so, so heavy. You would have to design something specifically for picking stuff up, because otherwise you have something that's capable of mass amounts of lift, but they require so much tweaking to maintain the altitude and stuff like that. You kind of have to use Lua to make it work. Yeah, Ben, there's a few repair bots on board, but there's obviously not enough. And yeah, the cram kind of goes poof. Trouble with it is it's largely high explosive. And the core is all high explosive, so if it takes one bad hit, it just goes up like a firework. And it takes ages to repair again. This thing isn't really built as a, you know, super duper combat ship. It was more for the aesthetics than anything else. I did sort of start out with that in mind. It wasn't meant to be an orc airship at the start, it was just meant to be an airship. Yeah, Lightning Dragon, they are a bit boring. It's the fact that they don't really do anything else other than crams. They probably spam a million repair bots. Make it suitably orky. Each one can be a grot. You can have hundreds of grots. I just spotted that's actually a really good place down there for them. Nope, not there. I want it on hull, please. Thank you. This is a perfect place for loads of repair bots. There. There we go. That'll speed things along a little bit. And the great thing about those little guys is they have free access to the outside because the big hole for the turret. Can't do the internal repair subship, Bill Snow, because it's too fast. You can only do that in ships that go below 30 meters per second. I tried to make a cram minigun, actually, and it is pretty much totally impossible. It would also be completely crap. Or it is completely crap, more to the point. I managed to get it up to... You see, the minimum fire rate that you can get on a cram cannon is about 2 seconds. Or it's like a 0.6 on a 200mm, which is like really pointless. It's not that fast. And by the time you add enough, you know, barrels to get a refire rate that isn't completely naff, it would be just... It's just absurdly big and also crap. They're just too heavily weighted towards high gauge. Gauge sort of applications. This is just so slow. Repair faster. I'm always wary of saving things whenever I'm repairing. Why you no repair? Airbots stuck everywhere. Wandering around. Hey little dude. How are you? What are you doing? Where are you going? Why are you not repairing things? Because there are things to be repaired. Little army of them here. Ah, there we go. They're actually doing something now. We have jobs assigned or something. I don't know. Am I not on board or something? Oh no, he is. He's working away. There we go, he's picked up. Sometimes I find that your character just has to stop repairing for no reason sometimes. Why repair paint them green? The repair debug thing is a real pain in the ass because you have to be looking directly at the block to repair it, I think. At least that was what it was like the last time I tried to use it, because I have it on the hotbar. But you kind of, like I say, have to be looking at the thing that's damaged. You can't just click the vehicle. Oh, it's actually repaired fully now. Let's save this and restart the designer.
part. Yes. Oh, you just gotta hold it down. Oh, okay, I feel like a bit of an idiot now. I will be doing that in the future. Thank you. That saves me lots and lots of dicking about waiting for things to repair, because I do that quite often. Because, like I say, I'm really wary of saving things whenever repairing, or whenever things are damaged. So I think we need more shields, I'm afraid. Like, lots more shields. Z. There. Nosiness satisfied? Okay, I think we do need more of the... more guns in the back. I think that's a good idea. And... would they work here? They might work here. No, there's not enough room for them there. But... this could totally be made into a firing platform. There. And there. Yeah, that's perfect. Use a slightly different shape for it, just to give it a bit more texture. Good. No, you. No, not you. You. And what I can do here is use my little sub-object cannons. Hidaka, 3 for it. Seems very big. Is that it? I think that's actually it. One of these ones. Yeah, they're probably more effective. These ones can always fire, whereas the other ones are entirely belt-fed. Not right. Not in the right place. Those appear to be in the right place. Oh, that's the particle cannons! Damn it! Okay, while I would love to leave them there, because they look actually really awesome, I don't have the power to fire them. Kinesian, the reason I don't paint in the color is because I often find that I delete blocks and change them in all the time. And, whenever you're, like, doing different, like, outlines and stuff like that, I find myself repainting things as I go too much. Right, I'm gonna leave them on then. We'll see if it works, but it probably won't work. Loads of object. It's the mini DACA one. You. Yeah, it was you. You're the one I was looking for. That's the boy. Right. I do need to... the blocks or C. Yeah, set these up. Set them up on the other side too. How did that one get set? They're on different cannons. Should be two different cannons. Why did they set? Aha, there you are. Weird. Okay, right. They should both be right now. I'm paranoid about this one now. Yeah, you're set. Yeah, whatevs. Working. Pretty sure it's working. Okay, I'll compromise. These ones are getting underclocked. Because otherwise it's going to absolutely rod my per engine. But it will still be firing. Still gonna stay there. I'm not in any way concerned about the cost of this thing, because let's be honest, it's got aesthetic parts everywhere, it's super expensive. Save it up. And let it fly off into the distance. Beautiful! They actually look like big engines now. Yeah, okay. Okay, I really like them. They look awesome. They look really awesome. Okay, so find something different. This will probably just blow me out of the sky, unfortunately. Let's find something weaker. Bashers, I think, are pretty weak. Nope, expert. As I say, this is not built for being super powerful by any means. Yoropigi. How the hell are you supposed to say that? Yoropigi? There we go, slasher. Regular. Are you serious? Is it dead? Freaking dead. Okay, so they're very vulnerable to EMP. Let's go for something a little bit more. See what happens when this thing opens up on us. That's a whole bunch of DACA. Oof. Didn't like that so much. I see how quickly all the shields got taken out by the particle cannons. Oof. Yeah, look, blanketed, all gone. On the top there. Unfortunately, the one at the front that is exactly where they have decided to aim is not getting... Oh. Oh, dude. Dude. That really hit the spot. Jeez. Boom. Okay, so that went pretty well. We could say. Very impressive, really. Really? Okay, I can't judge you. I think that's funny. That's a real dad joke, though. Yeah, I think that's definitely going to leave a mark, Ben. Definitely. That sort of a mark. The disappearing kind of a mark. Gone the Davy Jones locker. Right, let's get rid of you. Let's see if it's waiting on the despawn. Let's find out. What else can we shoot at? Steel Striders. What do you got? A Mulp. Mulp will probably crap on us. This is zero volume. Weird. Excalibur, this thing's enormous. Okay, this is probably the end of our ship. Ooh, missiles. Nope, they're following the flares. Oh, yeah. And then that one missed. Nice. Okay, so we've taken no damage yet. Nope, none. Nice. Flare system seems to be working admirably. Oh, the Fury. Fury would be a real challenge. But yeah, that is making short work of that Mulp. It's basically completely disabled by those few flares. I think the Mulp is largely torpedoes as well, though, isn't it? Oh, it's largely nothing now. There's big holes in it everywhere. Oh, the EMPs took out all of their cannon turrets. All of the AIs are gone. Is that it, or are they just not able to elevate to that altitude? No, it's miles away. The cannons are gone. I think the propellers are actually cranked up to the max now. Oh no, they're not actually. No, I think they're set to about 7. But they can go up to the 10, obviously. But the this Excalibur has not got a look in. Little missiles just cannot hit us. Ow.
That is quite a beautiful sight. Right there. Beautiful. Stunning. Devastating. Dhaka. Oh, Dhaka. Oh, the airy. The airy's normally pretty easy, and it also operates kind of similar to this guy because it primarily fights targets below it. It's not great at anti-air. Whereas this thing actually has quite a lot of little anti-air guns. But they all need to be actually reconfigured. Oh, AI dead. That's why it stopped shooting. There we go. Excalibur. No, not Excalibur. Someone mentioned the Fury. Fury is a real nightmare. It's a scary, scary ship. Go so fast. Let's see what happens. We do have those particle cannons, though. Ah, good luck hitting it with the cram. Hold on a second. Are you serious? That cram cannon hit. It didn't just hit it, blew it in half. Jesus. Yeah, that was effective. Who says crams can't hit fast things, eh? Guess that was maybe a little bit unfair. Yeah, I don't think he's too long for this world. MLG. That's an orc, man. You're supposed to be crap. It must have been a grot at the helm. Let's try that again, just to see if that was like a total one-off fluke. Further away this time, come on. There's the cram shell. Yeah, I totally missed that time. This is more of a fair fight, I think. Because we are losing bits this time. Our missiles aren't much good against this guy anyway. They're pretty slow burns. They're only short-range thrusters. You have another chance, though. Too far away to benefit from that. Where is that guy going? Back, coward. 4 kilometers away. Bad timing, because fired. Oh, I think we just blew our own nadgers off with that. There's a trouble with cram cannons under slung. They do like to shoot yourself quite a lot. But I guess that's suitably orky. Come on. No. No, that's too far away. Close, though. Close. Oof. Piece of shit. Right in the face. Urgh. Let's get back on board here. Oh, he totally took out her seat. What an ass. Ah, let me on. Ah! Okay, try it again. Try it again. Oh, we are stuck on board. Awesome. We have to walk to the helm. Fix the helm. I want my seat back, dammit. What do you call this? How did this even get destroyed? I guess they must have targeted that weapon system. That's probably a good point, actually. It's a bad idea having one there. Oh, hello. That's probably what happened. These turrets got destroyed and blew me up. That has been wont to happen. Where is it? Way over there again. It is winning, though. I guess that first one was just a lucky shot. A Nasher. A Nasher's one of the white flares, isn't it?
Yeah, sell the further drill bits. They're all powered as well. For no reason. Great talent, eh? Okay, right. Fury, I think we can count as a loss for now, although we did totally own him the first time. Best of two, we can call a draw. Sounds fair to me. Nasher. Guernsey. Great white. What is it? Alp! Oh, I'm not even in the Grey Talons, that would help. But what the hell are you? I have no idea what an Asher is. An Asher is terrifying! Good God! I think I'm gonna need two airships. Use this repair thingy. Oh my God, that's amazing. I love that. Okay. Oh, we're out of fuel. Okay, let's spawn a new one in. I think I made any changes to it. Okay. Oh well, let's see what a Nasher is. Where are you, Mr. Nasher? There you are. I will not lie, I'm a little scared. Where is it? Go and see what this thing is. Fuel use is actually pretty low. Red lines are quite efficient, and it only really burns it whenever the particle cannons are firing, which is only half the time, because they can charge in less time than it takes to fire again. Wow, that guy has a lot of firepower. Holy crap. This is ridiculous. This. Fly through the bullets. Jeez Louise. Pretty dramatic, though. What the hell are you? Pretty innocuous looking ship. Not very exciting, but totally kicking my ass. This looks awesome, though. It reverses? God, that is so annoying. One of these ships. I getcha. And I think it's winning pretty horribly. Ruger's a pirate lord in the backstory, really? I didn't know that. I knew he made the platform, but I didn't realize they wrote him into the backstory. That's pretty cool. I must admit, I haven't looked into the lore too much of this game. I did read some about the Deepwater Guard recently. I sort of blundered into Mace's post about it, and it's pretty cool. Oh, that hurt. Something hit him at last. Okay, something else hit him at last. It looks to be something of himself. Yeah, he blew his own willy off. That's never good. It wasn't me. I'm not responsible for it. Starting at such a distance probably didn't help either. You and your fighter, Bone Dragon. Well, I did actually see someone else made a pretty perfect little orc fighter. One like largely based on the ones from the tabletop. And we are still roughly in the air, but I think we're gonna crash now. But he's not doing so well either. Alright, what is happening here? We're losing altitude rapidly. And we've hit the ground. Damn it. No. Okay, it's now a land boat.
We are crashing. It was a pretty dramatic air crash, though. That was kind of cool. No, the turrets or the daddy blades on the top got destroyed. But that's I'm not cheating at all. Nope, not even in the slightest. I'm not using the repair thing. You can't see it on the hotbar because I've got the UI off. Ha ha ha! All of a sudden, we're back in action. Let's see how he does when I'm repairing infinitely. Piece of crap. But I guess we're taking on an arm shipped. Well, incomplete ship. Oh, good to hear, Coghatcher. Nice. Nice whenever you get a piece of equipment that just makes your ship work. Because that actually happened to me on the pointer as well. Although, to be fair, it's still pretty crap. What is happening? Why are we not going very fast? Just keeps getting that knocked off, dammit. These particle cannons on the back keep getting damaged. They can't really turn properly to shoot at frontal targets, which is probably bad. Whenever we cheat and instantly repair ourselves constantly, we can work. Works fine. I'm not sure we'll actually beat it, to be honest, because this thing is really powerful. Really powerful. They must be like fairly high strength shields. Oh my word. There's all those things on the inside. Internal daddy blades. You'd be ashamed of yourself. All of my daddy blades have clearance. Disgraceful. Oof! That probably wasn't very nice. Nope. Come on. Oh, that hurt. Actually did lots of damage. Awesome! Yeah, Lightning Dragon, I think you're right. I think reflect shields would be much better. In fact, we will do it just as you suggest too, and cheat with an aim. So, super quick way to set all of your shields to a particular type is activate whenever. Tell all your shields to turn to reflect and test. Done. Now they're all set to reflect instead of disrupt. And it's hard to know if they're actually doing anything. We actually need some at the top as well. All my shields are placed along the bottom. Oh no, we're losing altitude. No! We've lost our pitch thrusters. Our propellers. No, we haven't. What's happening? We lost the ACBs that control them. We have not. We are just getting destroyed rapidly. Ooh! Back to the cheating. Damn it, who suggested this? You should be ashamed of yourself. Thank you, Bald Rudy. Breeder, appreciate it. Putting wheels on a one turret? That work? That can't work. Surely you have to put the one axis on something. Well, I guess. Oh no, that's a perfect example of some time to ram. Oh, I think we are actually going to hit him. Yeah, we are! Ha ha! Boarding action! Now we're talking! No! No! No, 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 no! You're supposed to hit him! That's exactly when we needed harpoons. God damn it. Now he's going to tear up our arsehole with all that DACA. We have no shields at all on the back.
Yeah, ramming speed for sure. Well, they definitely seem to be working a bit better now. Some of them are still getting through, but, oh, ow! Shot by a Sobol round. That's nasty. Podcatcher, it's F11. Oh, got there ahead of me, Bone Dragon. I don't think I have your Fate Morgana, Elshigan. I don't think so. I might. Let's just restart the designer, because... Ooh, chug. Restart. I do not have it. No. Sorry. Let's find something else to shoot at. Seeing as that thing totally crapped on me. You're really showing up. Oh, yes, thank you. I will. I'll replace the one for Reflect Shields. I never actually once considered using a respawn beacon. That's a really good idea. Let us do that right now, because I think this is the perfect place for it here. Is it? I've never built one. Like, never. Respawning beacon. There. Will that work there like that? And we'll do the ACB for everything. I just realized you don't actually have to set any of these inputs. You can just pick your shields and use the test button. Shield, projectors, turn shields to reflect. Test. Done. And let's save it this time. Oh, we have to repaint the skull on the bottom for sure. I have to do the paint job properly. Got a lot to do on this. We've sort of mucked around for quite a while. Although we did get a lot of shields done. That's pretty good. There's still more to add. I wonder what sort of power we have left during combat. Find something else to shoot. Think of the Twin Guard. What are you? Phoenix. Probably huge. Let's see what it does. How's our power looking? 3,000. It's pretty tight now. Did spend a lot on shields, but we have room for a lot more. Down here and see how it's going. Isn't this Phoenix a carrier? I think it is. But I could be wrong. Don't get me wrong. I'm not being smug, I'm asking. Oh yeah, it has some ships. Oh, it's this bugger. That's right, he's a pain. That doesn't seem to be going so well for him. He's doing some damage to us, but... But he's crapping stuff out. But the whole, that whole section's got wrecked. That whole repair section's been held on by one beam. That one beam, right there. And all of the AIs are dead. Kinesian Empire, you are completely missing the point on the lasers. They're not actually connected, they're for aesthetics. I have advanced cannon gauges on the cram cannons. It's totally for appearances. I am not in any way concerned about the efficiency of the ship. All about the looks. The fact that it shoots anything at all is a bonus. I was making short work of this thing. So it does seem to have its place in terms of combat. It's got so much like little DACA that it sort of makes short work of all those little things. It would be really helpful if the AIs on the ship were on different... the turrets were all on different AIs. Because I think that is going to be really helpful, because it'll help it decide what it wants to shoot at a little better. Because at the minute, most of these are on a wireless on channel 1, and they're all on the same weapons AI. So if they can't reach their target, they don't like retract to another one, they'll try and aim at the one that's prioritized on that AI. So, yeah. Red with yellow drills is a flying fire truck. Yeah. That would be kind of awesome. Oh, the V-screen. Yep. Show the V-screen. Showed that off a while ago, but it was briefly. Oh, we've crept over the 1 million RP mark. Pretty heavy on the metal. It's not crazy expensive. It's just very expensive. Especially for in like cost to effectiveness ratio. Surprisingly, it's not too hard on fuel though, which is always nice. So we've got another half an hour or so on the screen, or on the screen, on the stream. I'll bring the Z key up for you, Nizian. Oh, what's a Seraph? What is the Seraph? You're gonna have to tell me a faction and stuff like that, because I don't know the names. Yeah, I was going to say, do you want to want me to play something a bit different? And we've been at this for an hour and a half now. So I'm open to suggestions for a quick game for like, you know, half an hour or so. Yeah, the repair skill's been nerfed heavily, Kinesian, so it's not actually as powerful as it would appear. Because there it is, the personal repair time and the vehicle repair time is only 0.2. It used to be like 0.0 to 0.1. So, yeah, can get nothing done in half an hour in KSP, unfortunately. Railgun. Robocraft again. It's kind of hard to get it all sorted. I haven't actually played Robocraft in about 6 months. Mechanic the nanite thing. Oh, okay, yeah, right, okay. Battlefleet Gothic's a pretty good idea. As soon as we're in the Orky stream, we'll do some more Orky stuff. But we'll have a quick skirmish game. Don't have Crossout, unfortunately. But Battlefleet Gothic, I should be able to fire it up and have a campaign done. Or, campaign. We'll do a skirmish or something like that. Give over the airship. And... oh, I'll pop the setup. Oh man, Sonic. Don't. Love that game. Played it so much in my youth. Up, down, left, right, ABC, start. Let's make it Orky. Ooh, I will fire up that other game. Does the things. This might be potentially very loud. So, just quickly... I'll go by with a set. Come on, you. Come here, the thing. Thank you. Oh, I just crashed my mixer. Bone Dragon, yeah, I'll put it on the workshop when it's done. Still a lot of work to be done on it, though. Come on, you. Thank you. I already have it turned way down. Erg. I'm probably got a black screen for a second here, sorry. There we are. Hey! Let's see, let's do a custom game. I have played a little bit on Skirmish, but I've been mostly playing the campaign. Cruiser Clash is just a fightiness. I like fightiness. Cruiser Clash. And Defender Attacker. No idea if that makes any difference. An AI. By the way, I'm crap at this game, so don't expect too much here. I don't have that much in terms of fleet points and stuff. Or like extra ships unlocked. Oh, it's a head crab. Hello, head crab. Here. Look. You have this game. Come here. Whoops. You're on the wrong channel.
That's cheating.
Hey. Hello. Hang on, I'm moving you the headphones.
Nokey dokey.
Get on to Battlefleet Gothic.
Oh my god.
Yeah, because you can do multiplayer.
Is that actually working now?
Well, yeah, it's in full release now.
Boop de pop. Okay.
Oh, where's the little window thing? Too many windows open. Jeez Louise.
Open all the windows.
No, too many windows.
Oh my god. Steam, what you do? Why you break PC?
Elshigan, if you're a big 40k fan, yeah, Battlefleet Gothic, you'll really enjoy it. But in terms of like a real-time strategy game, it's a bit lacking.
It's very different.
It is, yeah. It's a very slow-paced RTS game, which is honestly what I enjoy about it, to be honest, because the whole slow-paced thing is what makes it accessible for me as an RTS game, because I really suck at them. Full release. It is full release. What is the problem with that sentence?
Everything.
Everything? Damn it. You're offline. Why are you offline, Headcrab?
What do you mean, why am I offline?
You're offline, apparently.
What, on Steam?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it's probably because I broke Steam.
Oh, you broke it?
Yeah.
Yay.
Everything's going amazingly at the moment.
Oh, right. Now, how do we do a custom game? Arch.
Apparently, you know, Steam hasn't crashed. Microsoft Windows has crashed.
What, the whole Windows?
The whole thing.
Wow.
I'm just that good at this whole computer stuff.
Wow. That's really impressive.
And to think I get paid to do this stuff on a daily basis.
Oh my god, who's the fool? You are the ones paying you?
I'd like to say the ones paying me. Oh, and apparently now Skype is breaking.
No way. Maybe you did break Windows.
I think I just like severely broke Steam.
Typically good timing that, you know. trying to get something started.
Oh, okay. So like 10 minutes later, Hextrack decides to open.
Hooray!
Alright, making progress.
Are you back in the Steam yet?
No.
No, you're not.
I'm working on it.
Working. Work.
More work.
No, I don't have a Steam group, Bone Dragon. I do normally announce them on the YouTube channel with a little mini video and whatnot. It's probably the best way to do it for me. You can also get it on my Twitter, because I announce all my videos on Twitter, and it might be a little faster than the notifications from YouTube, but whatevs, you know. I'm sure you'll get spammed with them either way.
I have, like, severely broken things, so...
Okay, so I'm going to be playing a solo skirmish then.
For the moment.
God damn it. Okay, let's just get started and do something well.
I'm working on it.
Okay.
I promise.
Oh, it's not the internet connection. It is, his computer, I think.
Yeah, I'm breaking windows rather spectacularly at the moment.
Is it
I have no idea how I've done this.
Yeah, I will use a couple of these wee fellas as well. Okay, this is so many ships. I've never fought a battle this big before. in the grim darkness of the 41st millennium, there is only war. That is pretty much the entire sort of breaking concept for Warhammer 40k. Yes, I love breaking things. Breaking things is fun.
Breaking things is always fun. It's what I live for.
Let's just ready up and see what happens here. And I'll give them all AI control. Upward! Go on! Get them! Get them! You AI'd? No. AI. This is like ultimate fleet tactics. This is just drive straight at the enemy and shoot them. And drive through them. We have this big red button. Which I plan to press whenever we get close. Yeah, we'll go frontal. Full frontal. Ooh-er.
Kinky.
Bone Dragon. It's actually all the 40k universe. There is no fantasy. It's actually a world in the 41st millennium. And Games Workshop have confirmed as much and added it to the lore. It was often speculated, but Sigmar's hammer is actually a thunder hammer. And Sigmar himself is most likely a space marine.
Knowledge.
Yeah. I'm a big Warhammer nerd. Like the whole... I've read the whole history of the Necrons and all that, and the Cetan. It's so cool. Necron backstory. There's a wiki, a wikia, for Warhammer 40k that's sort of trying to put all of the stuff together into one sort of consistent, non-contradictory place, and they're doing a pretty good job of sort of putting it all into sort of a novelized format where you can read it all, and it sort of reads a bit like a novel, or more so like a history book, which is kind of awesome. Right, this is the chargey button. I have no idea what's going to happen here, but I presume this little fucker should be totally screwed. Nope. Oh, we hit him with one. We didn't hit him with any. Okay. Well, crap. Boarding action.
You are so dead.
Yeah, I'm going to lose really bad here. But, you know. Funsies.
At least it's fun to watch you die.
Yeah. Come on, you should be doing stuff. Well, actually, at the minute, we are winning. You go over here and deal with that prick over there. You can all shoot this bugger. Come on.
Have you updated the game you're playing, by the way? On Twitch.
Oh, I have not.
You boob.
I'm a boob.
I wonder, can I do it?
I don't believe so.
Well, you should fix that someday.
Yeah, working on it. Next.
Yay!
AFK in the middle of a battle, and we're winning. Why are we winning?
You shouldn't be winning.
Yeah, I shouldn't be winning. Oh, I are.
If I recall correctly, the whole letting of the people did it, they had to make him like a...
Ah, take that, you piece of crap. Yes! Oof. Oh, the other. I got a ram. I approved.
I do hope you've been renaming your ships.
Yes.
You know. Yeah.
Oh, this is just... I've only played a brief campaign. Mm.
You need to rename your ships to 90s boy bands.
Or again? Serious?
Yes.
Okay.
Or...
Ah. Oh, no, 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 you're not allowed to be destroyed. No, 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 no. I want that generator so I can warp away. Stop it. No! No! That's
the in a bit, Bone Dragon! Mwah!
See you later, dude. This seems like a bad place for this Chaos ship to be. Really, really does. I guess driving straight at them in a big blob seems to work quite well here. I haven't been paying that much attention. Have I lost anyone yet? I don't think so. You're in a bad place. Go away. Back, no. Turn around. Drive towards him.
Yes, this is head grab.
Drive towards him and drive straight through him. There. Right. Go. Come on. Last ditch. No! So close. I'm going to lose a little guy.
I hope you realize I still have no idea how to play this game.
Me neither. Why are you going over there? I probably told you to. Jeez Louise.
Yes, I can read your comments. What the fuck is your name?
I believe it's the Kinesian Emperor.
I'm going to have to agree
Emperor.
On that.
Sorry, yeah.
The Kinesian Emperor.
Emperor, yeah.
There you go, I said your name, as asked.
One of the more challenging ones, I must admit. Oh, this is all going bad for me now. Right. Charge. Come on. You got this. Oh. Are you serious? He blew up. Just before I got to ram him. This is just so rude.
I think it's just rude that you're trying to ram him.
Ah, no. Not.
It's completely rude.
I just want a hug.
It's the wrong kind of hug.
One of those sexual harassment case hugs. No, you are not pointing in the direction I told you to point when I hit the ram button. So rude. Man, fill up. I want to ram them again. Don't know why I want to ram everything now, but you know. Oh, that's perfect. You're looking right at him.
Hold on. What's this about pranking me with a pizza delivery?
That was his idea, not mine.
Oh, according to him, it was your idea.
That's a load of crap. I think you'll find Samyasa, you cheeky shit.
To be honest, I probably would have paid for it.
Run away. Well, I know you love pizza, so...
Oh, pizza's amazing.
Yeah. I had pizza earlier. Might have another pizza, actually. Not too late.
I've still got a calzone in the freezer. May have to defrost that for tomorrow.
I won.
Although the last one, like the last two, defeated me.
Where's you going? I'm running away. Where's my ships going? There's a number of ships to destroy one, but the last one escaped.
See, I don't know who to believe about this whole pizza thing now. It
wasn't me. Mostly because I don't... Well, you know that I don't know your address, so...
Ah, ah. But there are ways of you finding out.
Really?
Yeah. Do you remember the whole stream tip thing?
Oh, yeah.
Good point.
Yeah. Well, it tells you the town you're from. I mean, that's not really that useful.
It's close enough.
I got defeated. I think there was one hiding in the gas cloud. I don't know. It might have been a bug.
Yes, there is one in the gas cloud. Cloud? Cloud.
Out. Oh, okay. Well, I totally cocked that up.
Clowns. I sense clowns.
Clown?
Hats off to anybody that gets that reference.
My mouse pointer. Lost my mic. So have you got the game running?
I think. Things are happening.
I have no mouse pointer, which is irritating.
It's really bloody loud, though.
I noticed that. I have mine on, I think, 9 in the Windows Mixer.
I'm just, like, muting everything. All right.
Oh, this is really hard without, thing. The Ooge Bruiser. God damn it.
I have no idea what I'm doing, but I'm clicking buttons and things are happening.
Where are you? Invite.
It happened at the same time. I'm doing it.
You what? What happened?
I invited you to play just as you...
Oh, right.
You invited me.
Oh, right.
I don't know what's happening now. Join game, but nothing's happening.
Oh, bugger. I'll try and join you. I don't know what's happening.
Is this where you find out we've got to do this whole port forwarding crap again?
Good way.
To Google! Battlefleet Gothic.
I'm somehow going to try and find the bottom of the screen so I can rename my ship. Hard.
That's what she said.
Ugh. Seriously?
Sorry. I had to. You set me up for it.
I have to click this little button in the bottom middle of the screen. And it's impossible because there are no reference points nearby. Oh no. Oh no, I got it! Yes! Can I delete that now? Yes! The Ooge Cannon Cruiser is going to be called... House Martins. We're going way back here. Please let me have it. Come on. Ah, there's reference point. what?
So, all the orc ships have a mandatory underbite.
Yes, yes they do.
Oh, well.
Oh, well, that's actually a pretty good idea. Unfortunately, I can't get to this name button very easily here. This is a pain in the ass without a mouse pointer. Oh? What is ooh?
Ooh. Right, so apparently both players need to be in their multiplayer docks to be invited and to accept the invitation.
Okay.
Then you'll see both your pseudo appear on the invitation button. The invited player has his button grayed while the other can start searching for a match.
Ooh. What?
Stuff and things!
Oh my god, the whole not having a mouse pointer thing is a real pain in the ass.
Oh, restart the game then.
Yeah, gonna have to. Super quick restart.
Bloop.
Right.
I look away from chat for like one moment, and then I come back to Sammy saying, harder, daddy.
I noticed that. I didn't really want to comment.
It's like... what? Do I want to know? Do I
Probably
want to go
not.
Back and read the rest?
Why can I not name this one different? Oh, what the hell, the UI bug.
Oh, so is that how you rename? I mean, it won't let me, but I didn't realize this.
Yeah, you have to click the little arrow or the little button on the right.
Oh ho
ho! Oh hee ha hee ha!
Ho ho!
Wah! Ship strange delicious friends of the
Finisher.
Rot on a rock. And it's awesome.
Right, so hang on.
Hang on. Loop. He was in game.
Apparently.
Do you have to go into the multiplayer lobby? Is that
it? So where you are now, basically your hangar, where you're running through and changing things.
Yep.
That's where you invite people, apparently.
Okay. Well, there is an invite button here.
Yes. It would explain that, yes.
Which is what I tried to do last time.
That is a really cool looking black hole.
That's what she said.
Wow.
Sorry, but, you know. where are you now?
Places.
Other than recovering from that terrible joke.
There is no recovering from that.
just move on. So, I need to invite you.
I try to invite you.
Oh, okay. You're in the lobby, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Accepted it.
Did anything happen?
No. As in.
I wonder if you have to be the same... What's it called?
Action?
Yeah.
In order to be able to... It actually says that in the invite a player button. I'd invite you. Yeah, I've never actually had this work yet, so...
I have no idea what's going on! My nose is really running.
Arborus, yes, orcs do indeed travel on asteroids. The reason being orcs have their physiology is made up of two unique components, which is the not mammalian, but some sort of humanoid proponent, and then there's a fungal proponent as well, which is in the form of spores. Not AIDS. It's orcs, which is worse than AIDS. And yeah, the whole... premise behind the orcs are that the fungal component is like is the DNA that stores the base building blocks for the whole species, and then it spreads into the other parts and then disperses, a bit like stem cells do in humans. And they seed planets with spores. Yeah, this doesn't look like it's working.
No. Some people are saying that it's not even implemented yet, and others are saying, oh yeah, you gotta do this, this, and this, and then it'll work, and it's like...
Well, it's sending the invite and receiving the invite, it's just not bloody working. Boo!
Mm.
Boo. You're supposed to be able to do custom games as well, multiplayer.
Can you?
Apparently so.
Can you?
But I don't know
main
if
menu.
It's a... No, it's just got add AI now. Oh, can I do 2v? No, it's just add AI. Can't even change it. Nope, sadly not.
Oh yeah, you can only add AI. That's awful.
Yeah, I know, it sucks. Right, well, I think it's getting like Brilliant. We're over time already. So I'm going to do another... Yeah, yes. Yes, we are. The streaming's at 8 o'clock. I'm going to do another solo match thing. Hopefully win this time. Slightly smaller.
I should totes go and play Kerbal.
Kerbal? Mm-hmm. I haven't been playing it yet since the... The new changes.
It's weird.
Weird? Weird in what way?
I haven't played since the first iteration of the new aerodynamics.
Mm-hmm.
So with all the tweaks and everything they've done to that, so I launched a rocket that I knew worked in the past, and it just immediately flopped over. I was like, okay, you know that. I've been watching some of Scott Manley's live streams.
Yeah.
And he's created some of the weirdest things you'd ever see in Kerbal Space Program.
Really?
Yeah. He made something that can only be described as the human centipede, but with rocket parts.
Oh, the dragon.
Yes.
Oh my god, that thing was beautiful.
How does that thing work? How does physics... physics in that.
It does. It makes sense. It does because it exploits the lifting body effect in KSP. The only thing that it doesn't do terribly sensibly is the way that the parts stick together, because they really should break apart in a million different pieces fairly quickly.
Oh yes. I have no idea how that guy does things.
Yeah. I believe that one was a complete accident.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Still amazing, though.
Oh, yeah.
Who was the guy that kept doing those, random, challenges?
Oh, Hazardish.
Was it?
Hazardish, yeah.
Hazardish.
He does all the Reddit challenges. Yeah, if you guys like KSP and you don't know a guy called Hazardish, check his videos out. Holy crap, the guy is an amazing editor and a really, really impressive KSP player. Releases very few videos, but is, each one is quality.
That's it.
Vince the Skeleton.
Yeah, that's his YouTube username.
Oh, is it? Okay, yeah. Didn't know that. Well, that's Hazardish. Cool. I've watched pretty much all of his videos.
It's been a while since I watched any of his, though. Some of his creations, though, you look at it and you think, how does it exist, yeah. Let alone fly?
Yeah, I know. I mean, the ones that... I mean, he sent SRBs all the way to something like Eve and back to Kerbal again? I mean, how do you even begin to design something like that? Utterly mad.
So what... Have you seen his... to Tylo and back thing yet? In a single fuel tank.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That's right. Really impressive.
When he gets rid of the fairings as he reaches orbit, just to reveal the Kerbal.
Yeah.
So why?
Yeah, well, he's shaving weight. Don't need a capsule.
Surely, if he's bringing it back, he's going to kill the Kerbal.
No. But he did manage to land it back on Earth, didn't he? Or on Kerbin. Oh, bugger. No, those are explodey things. That's not nice. Ah, shit, there goes all my shields. Ow.
You watch Nexter's Lab? No, I've never even heard of Nexter.
I have heard the name, but I have never actually watched any of his stuff. Danny, I know, obviously. Danny is
Danny's
a bit
everywhere.
Of an inspiration for some of my videos as well. Orc songs. Is there? Yeah, do that. You were really bad shape, little man. No, I turned him the wrong bloody direction. Damn it. Damn it. I'm only half paying attention to this. Thanks, Ben. So Ben just sent me 50p. He donated 50p and said, give this to Headcrab.
Oh my god.
Which means you already owe me 50p because I tipped you £1 whenever we were testing it.
For fuck's sake, Ben. Oh wow.
I gotta disagree about Scott though, Kinesian, because I actually really enjoy his current videos. The Kerbal Space is Serious Business or whatever it's called. It's really interesting because of the amount of stuff he talks about real space programs, which is really interesting because I mean I love space stuff, but I'm not by any means a space nerd. So yeah, it's really interesting. This is going absolutely terribly.
That's what she said.
Oh no, missed. How did it miss? He was right there. Oh, Daka.
Apparently, Professor. Yes, I am.
No, you just have inglorious spending habits.
My spending habits are amazing.
Our words. Ah, no. Why did he turn at the last moment in the wrong direction? Not very bright, Mr. Orc, although I guess that's stupid of me to think anything otherwise. One. Point it at this guy and then smush him in the face. Big grams. That was suggestive.
Very.
This way, then. I really like the imperial of the whole high energy turn thing, because you can just basically do like skid to them, broadside the crap out of them at short range. It looks amazing.
So
important is
like your mind.
Important account. No, they have mines everywhere.
So, speaking of Scott Manley, so everybody's going on about him at the moment. Has he actually started a new Interstellar quest yet?
No, he hasn't. No. He's doing the Chaos Pure Serious Business one. Isn't it?
I quite miss the Interstellar quest one.
I loved Interstellar, yeah. I think I've watched it 3 times through.
I like it. I don't like it that much.
You see, I used to watch it whenever I was playing KSP on my second monitor, so I didn't really watch it, if you know what I mean. I only half watched it. But, the second time I played a similar mod pack that he did, I just had it on in the background. Oh, this isn't going so well. I am probably going to lose this. But, you know. Like I say, I do suck at this game a bit. It doesn't help that I'm sort of mostly reading chat.
Yeah.
I haven't played Halo since Halo 1.
On the Xbox.
Yeah.
I stuck with the original, and I loved it. I decided not to sully it. In any way, shape, or form.
With the PC imbalance is the thing that annoyed me the most. Because in the PC version of Halo 1, the most powerful weapon in the game was the pistol. Because 2 headshots killed. And that is crap on a console, because you can't aim 2 headshots very easily. But on a PC, when everyone else was playing Counter-Strike at the time, it was very, very easy.
Extremely so.
Yeah, especially with the slow Halo movements.
Oh, Sammy, yes, I do love pizza. But 50 of them is a bit much.
Oh, I won. How did I win? They all ran away.
Magic.
Yeah. It's a kind of magic. Victorious! Hooray! Oh, yes, that was Battlefleet Gothic. That's a fun game. I do recommend you have a look at it if you plan. Although I think a lot of people will have missed out on the pre-order bonus. There was a cool pre-order bonus that opened up the other factions in the DLCs, like the Space Marines that are coming along pretty soon. And for any that don't know, in the 40k universe, Space Marines and Imperial are actually two separate bodies. There's a whole load of bureaucracy and stuff in between them, so it's really interesting. But, yes, I am going to... that's mean, Nightbuck. Leave him alone. Although, oh, that's a warning. Good, he didn't kick you. That's okay. But yeah, I'm going to be wrapping the stream up here. So, have a good evening. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you very much for coming. And thank you very much for the tips and that sort of thing. I really appreciate it. It's really awesome. And we'll be streaming again probably fairly soon. Maybe next weekend. Maybe a little bit before. Depends what happens. But I will notify everyone on Twitch or on YouTube before it happens. So, yes. You want to say goodbye?
Yes, goodbye, everybody.
Bye-bye, everybody.
Mwah.
Mwah. As always, take it handy and have a bloody good day.